Hello and welcome to another episode of Two White Devils in a Microphone. Where we at?
We don't say.
That's right.
See, we don't actually say because that'd be just stupid. If we were like, this is our address at the beginning of every show, that's just asking for it, isn't it?
Yeah, we do not rep our hood at all.
we don't want spray paint on our hood. That's the last thing we need. We need to get dox ourselves.
Yeah, no shit. Yeah. Yeah, that was the running joke for all of the episodes, is that we never said where we were at. Yeah.
I like it.
So, yeah, I'm MC Ridiculous.
Yeah, and I'm MC Mad Max.
And we're taking a stroll down memory lane. We're kind of reviewing our greatest hits as I see it. Mad Max has not heard any of these tracks for, 5 or 6 years probably. So it's all new to him. I've heard them all 1,000 times a piece because I've had them for a while. So, yeah. It'll be fun to see what he thinks. And
that's part of the gimmick. Actually, hey. That's the whole gimmick.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the payoff, is that he hasn't heard these or himself in a while. And of course I've heard them all, so so yeah, this will be episode 6. Here is the first track off of that.
Back then, hoes didn't want him. Now they're all up on him.
Your verse is dope on this, though.
Sweet. Ridiculous.
And I might have thought you knew it, because I spit rhymes like tobacco when I chew it. All screwed.
Oh, yeah.
Let me get to rapping like JJ on Good Times. I'll tell you what's happening. Have your girls clocked on fire because she starts clapping. Energy vampire. So let me start sapping like Warren, because I'm thuffing in sacks. Never serving slack, so fiends run right back. There's something you don't know about me, Joe Rogan. I smoke crack.
I smoke crack.
Half circle forward punch when I attack. Hit you with that hot fire, make your jaw go slack. I'll snap. Ridic, you done did it again. But typed it on my phone, said the hell with the pen. And you can keep
Here's how
pad.
I know how to date this
I call my phone
one.
Michael Jackson, because that shit be bad. Samsung Galaxy S3, baby.
All right. Hey, Mad Max, Gemini on the horoscope. Wheels won't fit on the ride because they full of dope. Grab the 9, then pop up like a periscope. Hella dope. Second most real shit that I ever wrote. Take a tote. Ooh. And blast off to the stars. I rap like a drink. That's 32 bars. Got my own flag with 51 stars. That's one spot for every one of my battle scars.
Oh my God.
Battle starve and the skinny will eat when Mad Max begin to rhyme on the beat. Hit the street and move that weight. In 7 days more coming on pen and freight. I never wait. Early bird gets the worm. Here is today's lesson, cause you must learn. My thrust burn, so release the docking clamps as the crew from Wasteland burn through your amp. Then we vamp in the blue Scion. Take your girl, leave you with no shoulder to cry on.
Shout out to
bygones,
the Scion.
Bygones are bygones. Now just be gone. MCP on. Heat on. And ready to cock it. Ridiculous. Grab the mic, then start to rock it.
Oh,
I was not ready.
We did a lot of throwing it back and forth, though. You know.
All right. Yo.
I snatch your spine out like a Sub-Zero fatality. Hope they don't sue us, unsure of legality. Just remember that the show is a parody, so I can ask Tara Reid if she will marry me. It's scary, see
what?
How I flip these arms so easily. Have your girl clean my house like she was Mrs. Biggsley. Live in girls. Bars like I'm Scrooge McDuck. You MCs wanna battle me, you gonna be fucked. And when I grab this mic, you're gonna get stuck. Hose you up, all mean, hang you up when you're stuffed. Put you out your misery, cause enough is enough. You suck, hell, I did the world a favor. Should've listened to Craig Mack and come with new flavor.
Mm-hmm. Oh, in your ear. Mad flavor in your ear, like Mike Tyson.
What?
Pac-Man flavor.
You're all over Iron Mike.
Oh yeah, you get on Mike's ass a couple of times.
I think there's nothing wrong with that whole last bit. I think yeah. I'll put that up. That's good. I can dig it.
What? Yeah. I snuck in two verses on that one. And then you had a dope, super long verse. You know, I've actually written a not so much a rebuttal verse, but I guess a shout out verse to that verse. You know.
Interesting.
So
sounds like some Eminem shit.
Look forward to that one. But that was all written, by the way.
That's fine.
Yeah.
I decree it fine.
Oh no. I mean, it is fine. I just want folks to know that, like, yeah, we weren't freestyling on that one or nothing. You know, actually, we wrote all of these for this episode. No. I do have one freestyle on here from me.
All kinds of rappers like looking at their phones these days in 2018. So, you know.
Yeah, we were doing that in 2012, fools.
That's right. Representing someplace.
I was typing my shit out on the phone way before y'all. So, in this clip, Danny has tasked me with rapping about buying an old dog nobody wants from the pound.
Back then, hoes didn't want him.
Oh my god.
Now they're all upon us.
Oh god. Alright, let me hit the right button here.
Wow. Well,
alright. The lighter.
Alright. Yep. Here we go. Ridiculous, and I was feeling down. To up with my spirits, I hit the pound. Yeah, I walk in, go to the room where they hold the kittens. They were too young, I wasn't smitten. So over to the dogs, I started kitten. Yeah, that's where love I was bitten. When I saw a dog that was flea bitten. He was old and gray, and his legs wouldn't allow him to stay. Only trick he knew was to sit. Yeah, and I knew that was the shit. Looking for a dog that I don't have to walk. Cause I don't wanna go around the block. He just lays down around that clock.
It does.
Yeah, it's still and true to this day. Spot,
except to get up and maybe go piss. Yeah, this he didn't. Fuck this. He didn't unlearn. Yeah, but it took an unfortunate turn. He only lasted 6 months.
What?
Back rest to in the peace. Pound on the hunt.
Oh.
I think I might get a run.
He was incredibly old, according
Mad
to Danny.
Max on the stunt. Yo. Sitting at the car wash, black whip.
Man.
So, yeah.
That's good. Good.
I now currently have two dogs and they're in fine health. So.
This is back to the format of the earlier episodes where we're taking requests.
Yeah, Danny makes an appearance on a lot of these, and yeah, he tasked us with rapping about super ridiculous shit that nobody would ever rap about. Commercial airliners, fresh produce, food stamp fraud, fucking buying an incredibly old dog from the pound.
Right.
Yours seems was going through the car wash and cleaning up a sweet tea spill your homeboy told you to clean up.
That is eerily specific.
2 months ago, yeah. Real life events, folks.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So yeah, like I said, you know, just off the dome, I didn't think it was too bad.
No.
Yeah. So here's our last clip for episode 6. Dusty's got a pretty dope verse, and I was pretty happy with the way that mine turned out here at the end. So here we go.
Yeah. Yo, Mad Max, Wasteland Studios. I'm here with Redick and Danny, who just don't care for it. Yo, I only drink Blue Label. I only flinch when your girl's under the table.
You know I'm able to pull a cane on that ass. Super fast, super class, and up to the task. I move fast, so you better keep up. Hip hop low blow, better wear your cup. You know what's up, Mad Max on the set. Like a night in Vegas, give you shit to regret. You let them see you sweat, cause you fucking with a vet. Cold stare and a grill that you best forget. Purple on the corner and white in the alley. Keep me in a crispy new set of those ballies. Former rally, lodge a formal complaint. Cause Mad Max ripped the shit in a way that you can't. Caution wet paint. As I paint the wall red, I got a flow and a style that you'll never forget. I start to spit, then it's all over. Next time, double up on the dose of ginkgo biloba.
Ridiculous. Oh my God.
Start to spit.
I leave you slipping like Curious George left a dinner on the floor. To pull a scorpion and say, come here, whore. You want more? Fine, here it goes. Like this coke when I put this straw to my nose.
Allegedly.
I inhale.
What?
Yeah, straight to the sinus. Then get lost in this music like my name was Linus. Have your hoe be a goofy like her name is Lucy. Slip her a Mickey, then watch it get goofy.
I didn't
while
know
God's shit.
Like Donald's on these thin, that's mini. Then poof in my pants like my name was Winnie. Oh bother, should I go any farther, or should I cut these cats down like hair to a barber? If I'm in your house, then a fugitive you harbor. Call me the thing, cause MC's a clobber, a clubber. Like my name was Lang, my prediction for this fight, pain.
Pain.
I don't want to kill other MCs, but I pity the fools. I'm the champ.
He still reps it. Still reps talking three to this day.
All right, hey, JR, do the outro on the beat like we talked.
Plus, I don't think that's the last reference I make to Mr. T in fucking Rocky 3.
I'm glad you noted that for the archives.
Yeah, it's the best. Yeah.
That's what you say.
Well, okay, let me not get it twisted. Everything with Mr. T in it is the best.
Okay.
Everything Got without it. Mr. T. Except for Mickey dying, that was a tearjerker. Spoiler warning. Yeah. For a 30-year-old movie. But yeah, that was us. That was us for episode 6. There was some other stuff that was in there, but I didn't think it was great. So yeah.
Yeah, you know, we're doing
revisionist
like
history.
I was having less of a fake voice inflection in the later episodes, you know what I mean? Like, I was...
Yeah, we start to kind of find our comfort zone, I guess. Mm-hmm. You know, but yeah, it definitely doesn't sound, I don't know, like not as fake, I guess, but not, I don't know,
we
not
had
as
no
forced.
Idea what we were doing.
Well, I mean, listening back to it, like, to hear just my regular voice, I don't think anybody would be intimidated by my raps. You know, I make some bold claims, but when it's coming out of this vocal cord, it's not as intimidating. Yeah.
That's in the early episodes.
No, that's just through the whole series. I'm chronically low because I don't project my voice. And
oh, man.
I've got my voice, so when I'm threatening you, you just got to be like, what is this accountant threatening to me with? You know what I mean? Like, it's...
I didn't expect this to be so introspective.
Like I said, I've heard myself on these thousands of times. I've come to grips with it. You know what I'm saying?
What changes will this mean for the mixtape?
We need to get the band back together.
Maybe something with Tokyo Black, who knows.
Oh yeah, another Tokyo White could be.
Oh, could interesting. Tokyo be. White 2019.
Yeah, we're carrying on the tradition of writing checks our ass can't cash.
Yep, writing raps.
We teased a mixtape like 7 episodes into it, and it's 9 years later. It never saw the light of day.
Each episode's like a mixtape.
Yeah, it really is, though. Yeah, you're right. So I guess in a half, we've ass backwards fell into keeping that promise.
Yeah. 13 times.
Yeah. Yeah, it's dope. They just get better from here. Episode 6 I thought was pretty solid. It was a good building block on episode 5, which I thought was where we blossomed. Like, from 7 on, then we get, I don't know, we make some leaps. Yeah.
Really?
With the next successive, yeah, episodes, I think so, yes. Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. I think glad to hear that.
Well, I can't say each episode, because episode 8, I was like, meh. So I kind of chucked it. The whole episode was meh. Yeah. Not because of this, but my sister guest stars, and she's not bad for, you know, just coming on and doing it just straight up, but there wasn't nothing that blew my mind about it, so we skipped that one. We were being
too experimental in the format.
Yeah, we definitely got out there for sure. There was some hastily written stuff that wasn't that great, and then there was some freestyle that wasn't that great. So the whole episode's mediocre at best. Yeah.
Damn. All right.
Yeah, like I said, revisionist history.
Yeah. We'll get to that on that episode, the retrospective.
Yeah. Maybe we'll have a bloopers episode. Maybe I'll cut a bunch of shit where we just suck ass and then we gotta sit through it.
Oh, yeah.
Take our lumps like a man. Yeah. That
sounds like a nightmare. Should be interesting.
It'll be cringeworthy for sure. You'll just be like, oh my god. Yeah. We'll put that one up for debate. Or I'll tell you what, if 30 different people write in to the email. Here we go. tokyoblackhour@gmail.com. If 30 different people write in, we'll post our blooper reel of the
worst of our shit.
Wackest of the whack.
It's frightening. I'm shook just thinking about it.
Yeah, we'll have a Whacktacular Hall of Fame. You know what? I'll put us on sale too. 20 people. 20 people write into tokyoblackhour.com.
Oh, okay. It's fair. I can dig it.
Yeah, we'll do one episode of us where it's whacktastic.
Oh my god.
Our greatest misses. So yeah, I guess this is it for episode 6. I don't know, what'd you think, Dusty?
I thought it was some pretty fine material, actually. I'm pleasantly surprised. It's not all, I thought it'd be all like completely unplayable, like, you know, just us talking about some shit that's like way too explicit for this new sensitive era, but not really, you know.
Yeah, no, we don't get super, super controversial. Some could say they were a little misogynistic at best, but
true.
I mean, you know, it's a parody and a comedy, and you know. We ain't really slapping hoes.
No.
Unless they're late with the sandwich. Yeah.
I don't endorse any of this.
I may make some references later on that are not going to be kind to me in this delicate climate, but I stand by them.
All right. That's when we'll remind you again that it's a parody and we're just saying this stuff to shock you.
Yes. And I don't know, does Tara Reid make any more appearances? I want to say she does.
After we saw her at Dragon Con?
I don't know, but she pops up in the raps a few times, so yeah. I'm just trying to think if anybody.
We might as well get our beef with Tara Reid back up and running.
Well, she just lost that Sharknado fucking paycheck every year, so.
It's crushing.
Probably needs to get back in the public eye. Mm-hmm. TokyoBlackHour.com. Write in Tara Reid.
Right. Tara Reid, Panda Girl.
Well, now that'd be something.
Yeah, it would.
That would
we be know some people.
Yeah, yeah, we'll get you hooked up. Free t-shirt, Tara Reed, right in.
That's right, that's right. You got to compose in Atlanta, and unfortunately it's like 56 degrees right now, but...
Nah, we'll put you in a hotel. Yeah.
That's nice.
We're not paying for the room. We'll just get you in a hotel so you don't have to shoot outside, you know?
Right, right.
We'll get you out of the cold.
Mm-hmm. When we saw last time we saw Terry, she was in a hotel. getting a drink at the hotel bar.
Yeah, you're right. Show you're right. So...
I mean, that ain't no joke. Just seriously.
But yeah, on some real shit, yeah, we did see Terry Reed at a bar.
Yeah, in Atlanta. I mean, wherever we record from.
Atlantis, he meant to say.
Somewhere in the city of Atlanta.
That's all right. I'll bleep all this out.
I was wondering, it's like 14 episodes and then it's revealed.
Okay, I like it. Yeah, after fucking 15 years, we finally reveal where we're at.
Somewhere in Atlanta. 20 million people a day go through here, but...
Yeah, busiest airport and whatnot. Yeah, mm-hmm. So
we live somewhere in the airport.
We're like Tom Hanks. Only more evil.
We rip our tarmac.
Rep our terminal.
Yeah.
D-side.
The 11. Sparrow.
Chick-fil-A, what?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Alright, well, this has been episode 6. I've been MC Ridiculous.
I've been MC Mad Max.
And tune in next week for episode 7, where shit gets crazy a little bit. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, I go off the chain a little bit. So.
Wow, really?
Oh, yeah, I'll toot my own horn here. Yeah. So
can't wait to hear this.
All right. I'll see y'all next week.
Good night.